take it to him. Wonderful opportunity here, certainly for Uganda on the back of their quite remarkable.
Uganda top rugby player Philip Okoroch, trading his mark at AS Bedarides in France, believes it's going to be a tougher test for Uganda Rugby Sevens to punch its way to the 12 HSBC Rugby Sevens with a new qualification format. The World Rugby Sevens Challenges series is now barely 16 weeks away as Uganda Rugby Sevens prepares to battle with 11 other nations in Cape Town, South Africa, seeking to top the series and enter another 14 playoff, which will be featuring the bottom teams from the World Challenges series at the London Sevens in May. The winners here will then achieve the core status of HSBC World Series in 2024. With this new format, Philip Okoroch believes we need to start preparing now to achieve the status quo.
The new format has advantages and disadvantages. I think the advantage is for the betterment of the competition, that is the seven. By the time you're promoted, at least you're going to compete, not to just go and be beaten over 100 points in just 14 minutes. So it shows that the game is not growing. And the disadvantages will affect Uganda more because it's now a bigger challenge than before. So we have to play against the last teams in the top series coming down, because we coming from down, it will be a bit hard for us, but for them it will be easier if they keep the same players or the same management. They can easily go back because they've been in the system and they have the exposure and everything. For us, as a struggling nation, we shall always struggle, but still it doesn't take away the chances. If we prepare well, I believe we can always win and get promoted.
Philip Okoroch, who trades his mark in French lower division rugby club Avena Portif, targets new heights this year with his club.
So back to the union, better preparations will always win you games. Club-wise, we started off the season well. Personally, I'm the top point scorer in our league, and I hope we can get better and even get more points.
He has emphasized the need to improve on local rugby grass structures, a factor that will help more Uganda rugby upcoming stars to penetrate the international rugby ranks.
For me, I think the grassroots rugby is the foundation of rugby. So if all the clubs get involved in nurturing kids from a young age, I'm sure they'll have players coming in for like 5 to 6 years. Unlike these days, these past years, that I think Ugandan rugby relaxed a bit on the foundation, and that's why you see schools rugby, the competition went a bit down, but in my time, schools rugby was prime, and that's why you see the national team has so many players that were in schools during that time. So if they go back, tackle this, I think we shall have a number of players coming in. And also, even if he cannot play rugby, but at least he has been introduced to the game when he's young, in depth, because he understands the game, and that's how we shall tackle the problem, say, promoting the sport, which we all want to promote the sport so that the corporate world can come in and sponsor the game, and that's how the game will grow.
He'll be flying back to France this week.